Tonight we're coming to see the graduate exhibition of the Industrial Design Programme. Design is what happens at the front end of manufacturing. It's the humanising of technology. What we see here tonight is the final major project with real clients, real products, and in many cases, real IP has been realised by doing these projects.
I designed a portable cable dolly system, a small bit of equipment that will fit in a backpack. Take it off mountain biking and you can put it on a cable and then get a tracking shot. Spin this up to speed and then that stops this action.
I worked on a wine packaging. It's made from a lightweight aluminium with a bamboo core. Companies can put their own logo on it. It has these adjustable tabs that mean that you can put different size bottles.
My project is about a customizable watch. Choose a shape and a color of the top plate and a design and color for the dial itself.
It's our job to try and identify opportunities that come from the research that gets undertaken at the university to try and get them out into the community where they can actually have a benefit. The innovations and designs that we see downstairs has the tremendous impact and opportunity to do that.
I was approached by some clients interested in vending food from a bicycle. So I looked at how the bike could be joined onto a standard bicycle. So you have a mountain bike sitting at home, then you buy this sled, it attaches on, and you're able to carry upwards of 150 kilos on the back of your standard bike.
I've designed my camper trailer so there is no canvas on the outside when it's packed away. The walls of the camper are made out of Laminex metalline, which is traditionally a kitchen splashback material. If it's bad weather, you can do your cooking here, and everything just pops out as you open it up.
I designed a hyperkid injector. It's a medical device that diabetics use. It's the opposite of an insulin injector. If someone's unconscious, dying in front of you on the ground, you need to use it as quickly as possible. You twist it, and then you shake, and then you stab into the side of the leg, and that's the entire process.
Also, I've been involved in the African solar taxi. It's a solution to get pregnant women in Zimbabwe to hospital. It's an electric vehicle, motors in the back wheels. We're using ATV tyres for really rough roads. The electricity will be coming from a solar charging station, and it needs to be comfortable enough to travel up to 2 hours.
The first wave of designers coming out as Holden's closing are going to be right at the very forefront of the change in manufacturing in Australia, and that's, to me, seems very, very exciting.